Hello everyone, I am Ramya. So last class we are seeing the first topic in the Unix system programming, that is ANSI C standard. So we are studied the ANSI C standard. So we know that what is ANSI C standard, right? So we are for the C programming, the ANSI, that is the American National Standard Institute, they introduced the standard for the C programming language. So that we are going to call it as a ANSI C. So we are studied, so what is ANSI C, what are the different versions of the C programming, and also we are seeing though what is the difference between the ANSI C and the K and RCC, right? So now in today's class we are going to study though the C++ standard. So now let us see American National Standard Institute and the International Organization for the Standard, they introduced the standard for the C++ programming language, that we are going to call it as a ANSI ISO C++ standard. Now let us see what is this C++ standard. So C++, which is a derived from the C programming languages. So we know that what is C programming language. Now the C++, which is derived from the C, so the C++, which is what? Which is a programming language. What type of programming language? It is a object oriented. What it is? It is a object oriented programming language. So that is about the C++. So now this C++ is developed by Benjamin Stroustrup in the year 1980s. In the year 1980s at AT&T Bell Laboratory. Bell Laboratory. So this person introduced or developed the C++. Which is going to give the standard, that is ANSI ISO C++. So now we are going to study though what is the C++ latest compiler. So the latest compiler, the C++, is 3.0, that is version 3.0. So what it is going to support? So other than C programming, what else we are going to study in the C++? So we are going to study the many feature in the C++. The compiler is going to support the many feature like classes, derived class, next virtual function, virtual class, then operator overloading, inheritance, polymorphism, and then though the class template, class functions. So all this feature will be supported by the C++ compiler at the version 3.0. So this is about the ANSI ISO C++ standard. So similar to the C programming, the ANSI and the ISO together, they introduce a standard for the C++, which is developed by the Benjamin Stroustrup in the year 1980s at the AT&T Bell Laboratory. So during that time, they came with the many versions. The latest version is C++ compiler, so that is version 3.0, which is going to support the many features like the inheritance, polymorphism, class, derived class, operator overloading, virtual function, templates, all these features which is going to supported by this C++ compiler. So now let us see what is the major difference between the ANSI C and the ANSI C++. So let us study the third topic. So let us study the third topic, that is difference between ANSI C and though C++. Now we come across what is ANSI C and though what is ANSI C++, right? So let us study the differences. We are having plenty of differences, but here we are going to concentrate though three important differences between the ANSI C and C++. So the first one, function prototype. So function prototype, as we know that in the ANSI C++, the function prototype is compulsory. That is, whatever the function you are going to write before calling the any function, it should contain both the function declaration and the function definition. So let us see the example, the first example for the function prototype. See here, we are going to make use of the function foo. See, this is what the function prototype, right? So it contains the return type, function name and the argument list. So after that, we are going to call write the function definition. So that is int foo int a. So when you are going to call the this function, so for example int foo, so here consider int result is equal to foo of 10. So this is what you are going to call, right? So when you are going to call this function, it is going to check both the function prototype as well as the function definition. In which one? In the ANSI C++. So it is a mandatory to write the function prototype. So now without using this function, suppose for example, if you are not going to write this function prototype and you are going to call this function foo 10, right? So here it is going to take the value int a, integer value. Now suppose for example, instead of that you are going to pass the character. So in that cases, it is going to give an error. So what that error, that is linking error, it is going to produce. In which one? In the ANSI C++. So that is the mandatory. Suppose for example, same function definition and you are going to call this one. So you are going to call this function, that is foo a, so it is not going to need the function prototype. So which one? That is ANSI C. So ANSI C is going to create its own default function prototype. So when you are going to call this function, it is going to create its own default function and it is not going to give any error. So that is what the disadvantage in the ANSI C. So it is not mandatory that you have to write the function prototype in the ANSI C, but here before referencing any function, you have to should include the function prototype and the function definition in the ANSI C++. So that is the first difference between the ANSI C++ and the ANSI C. So let us study the second differences, that is function declaration. So what is this function declaration? Let us see with the example. I am going to take the same function, that is the function foo with the int foo. So this is the declaration what we did in the ANSI C++ as well as the ANSI C. So while taking this function, what it is going to do means this function is going to be rewritten as a like this. So what is this? That is int foo dot dot indicate that it is going to take the number of arguments. That is, you can pass the many number of arguments for this function, in which one? That is ANSI C. So this statement will be rewritten by the ANSI C, that is int foo dot dot dot. Dot dot indicate that in future it is going to take the many number of the argument. So what about ANSI and C++? So same function, you can take the same function int foo and it is going to be treat this function like int foo void. So the same function the same function declaration is going to be used in the C++, that is int foo void. So that indicate, the void indicate that it is not going to take the argument. That is, it may not take the argument, that indicate that void. So this is what the second difference between the ANSI C++ and the ANSI C. So let us now the type safe leakage. So the external function, if you are going to make use of the any external function, so it is going to make use of the type safe leakage in the ANSI C++. But in the ANSI C, it is not going to support the which one, that is type safe linkage. So that is what the major difference between the ANSI C++ and the ANSI C. So what is that external function make use of type safe leakage technique? So let us see with the example. See here, I'm going to write the function int foo, and then it is going to take the character and you are going to write this one. Then after that you are going to call this function. See, now the same example I am taking, that is function foo, the argument it is going to take is in integer value, right? So only one argument is there. So while calling this function, while linking this function, so this called function is going to link with the what function definition, right? So it is going to take this function and foo allow. So what is this type, the argument we are passing, that is the string type, right? So when you are going to pass the string type, so it is not going to match the whatever the parameter is there for the function definition, and the calling function is different, right? So in that cases, the C++ is going to use the technique, that is type safe leakage. Now it is going to give an error. In which case, in the C++. So in the support C, in the C++, it is going to give an error. That is the type safe leakage error it is going to produce. Now in the C++, if you are going to use the same thing, it is not going to give the any type of the error. So there will be a chance of crashes, right, in the ANSI C. So this is the difference between, three main difference between the ANSI C++ and the ANSI C. So now we are studied, that is ANSI C standard. Second one, we are seeing that ANSI ISO C++ standard. Now we are also seeing that what is the difference between ANSI C and the C++. So now let us study the fourth topic, that is the POSIX standard. First we will see the introduction, what is this POSIX standard. So before going to that, so let us see though what are the different type of versions is there in the Unix. In the Unix operating system, there will be plenty of version is exist today, right? So like for example, I written the few example, that is BSD Unix, and then the Sun OS, System V, and the AIX. So many versions are there in the Unix operating system, right? So each of these operating system, each of these versions of the Unix operating system is going to provide its own API. What is that API? That is the application program. What is that API? API is nothing but the application program. Application program interface, right? Interface. So that we are going to call it as a API. So each of this version is going to provide its own type of APIs, right? Suppose for example, the BST is going to support the set of API, the system V is going to support its own set of the API, the Sun OS is also has its own set of the APIs, right? So there will be plenty of APIs is there in its corresponding version, right? Suppose for example, I am a developer, I like to develop though some application. So now if I like to develop the application, that is for example, if I am like to develop the application for the student management. So in that cases, I have to make use of this API. So if you are likes to write the project for the student managed for the BSD, can you write the APIs, the BSD by making use of BSD API? Now if you like to create the student management application for the system V, then you have to make use of the system V API. If you like to develop the same application for the Sun OS, you have to create the Sun OS API, make use of these APIs. So for creating a single application, that is student management, you have to know all these APIs, you have to learn all these versions of the Unix operating system, right? So there will be a difficulty, right? So to overcome that problem, what is the solution? So instead of writing though the application for each and every versions of the Unix operating system consumes a time, right? What type of problem we are facing, that is though portable. So there is a no portability between the BSD system V and the Sun OS. So to overcome this problem, to provide an interface between these APIs, between these versions of the Unix operating system, the IEEE, so IEEE organization developed the which one, that is Special Task Force. So which is going to develop the Special Task Force, what we are going to call it as a POSIX. So what we are going to call it as a POSIX. So what is this POSIX is? So the POSIX is a standard. So standard, right? So what it is going to give? It is going to give the standard APIs. Which is going to give the standard APIs. All these standard APIs should support the BSD system V and the Sun OS. So if the user likes to develop this system student management by making use of this POSIX standard APIs, then all that different versions of the Unix operating system is going to support. So you can easily port this student management application in all this version. So that is what the advantage of making use of the POSIX. So what it is going to give in a single word, interface between this type this versions of the Unix operating system. So that is why we are going to study this topic. Now what is this POSIX full form? So now the POSIX full form, what it is? So the POSIX full form is nothing but the what it is, that is portable OS is nothing but operating system. So what is this indicate? Interface. So as the name says that the portable operating system interface. So this is going to provide an interface for the different types of the version which is present, right? So this is nothing but the POSIX. In this POSIX, we are having three important sub-version. So first one is POSIX.1. Next, POSIX.1b. Next, POSIX.1c. Let us study what is the difference between this POSIX 1.1, POSIX.1b, POSIX.1c. Now we are going to study what is the different subversions of the POSIX. So we come across the POSIX will be gives the standard for the APIs of different versions of the Unix operating system, right? So we are studied that the POSIX.1, POSIX.1B, POSIX.1C are the different sub versions of the POSIX. So what are they? So what is the difference between them? So for which operating system going to be used for which versions of the POSIX? Let us see with the examples. That is the stand the POSIX.1 and the every version is going to support for the standard API, right? So that is it is going to provide the APIs. So the POSIX.1 going to support the APIs, that is the application program interfaces for the which operating system, that is the base operating system. So some of the example is Ubuntu. So gives the APIs for the file operation and the process operation. Suppose for example, you like to open the file, then you are going to make use of the open API, that is open system call. Now, if you like to close the function, close the file, then you have to make use of close, right? So if you likes to read the file, then make use of read system call. So all these basic system call will be supported in the base operating system, that is POSIX.1, that is the files and the process, that is for the manipulation of the files and process. For example, to create the process, we are going to make use of the system call, that is fork, right? So in that cases, we are going to make use of all these system calls, that is the standard. You can make use of this system call for reading, writing, opening, closing and creating the process. This is the standard system calls that you can make use of in the POSIX.1. So what is the standard? We are the IEEE is given is IEEE standard, that is 1003.1 1990s. So in the 1990 the POSIX.1 version came into exist. So this is the standard the IEEE is given for the POSIX.1. So let us study the second one, that is POSIX.1P. So POSIX.1P, which is going to create the APIs, that is which is provide the standard API for the real time operating system. So this real time operating system, which is going to make use in what? In the real applications. In the real application, we are going to make use of the real-time operating system. So what is the advantage of making use of this real-time operating system? That is nothing but it is not going to give the any delay. Some example, in the airline, you can make use of this real-time operating system. So in the weather monitoring, you can make use of this real-time operating system. In the patient controlling system, you can make use of this real-time operating system. So these are the real-time operating system advantage. For that, the POSIX.1B is going to give the standard APIs. So it is also going to support the inter-process communication. So we know that for executing the program, the internal operating system is going to create a process for the execution of a program, right? The program under execution, we are going to call it as a process. There will be plenty of process will be created by the inside the operating system for the execution of program. To provide a communication between this process, we are going to call it as a inter-process communication. So this API is going to be created to make the inter-process communication. So that is the POSIX.1B. What is the standard? That is IEEE 1003.4 1993. So this is the standard which is the IEEE is given. So let us study the POSIX.1C. So POSIX.1C, which is going to support all the features of the POSIX.1, POSIX.1B. So as well as it is going to support the one more important feature in the programming language, that is multi-threading. So we know that the multi-threading, how it is going to work, right? So this POSIX.1B is going to support for the multi-threading in the program interfaces. So for what purpose we are going to use the multi-threading? To make use of the multiple user. So operating, any operating system which is going to support the multi-threading is nothing but we are going to perform the given task at the same time. That is nothing but the multiple user is going to access that operating system at the same time, and he is also going to perform the many operation at the same time, right? So that is nothing but the advantage of using the multi-threading in the program interface. So the standard which is going to support is the 1003.6/1995. So this is what the different versions of the POSIX. Now let us study though what is the constant it is going to support, how you are going to include this different version in your program. So let us see with the example. So let us study though what are the manifested constant which is supported by the POSIX operating system. It is ASH defined POSIX source. So ASH defined POSIX C source value. So these are the constant we have to make use in the each and every source program. So see POSIX C source value. This value which is going to take the three values, that is 1988 08 L. So that indicate that the first four letter that indicate it is a year. Second two letter that is indicate it is a month. So what is this last letter, that is L, indicate that it is a long integer. So this is how we are going to represent the value here. So when you are going to give this 1988 08 L, then it is going to support the first version of the POSIX.1. So now second one 1990 09 L, it is going to support the second version of the POSIX.1. Now month 09 and then the long integer which is going to support both the POSIX.1 as well as the POSIX.1B. So these are the three values which we are going to make use while defining the constant. So here instead of value I'm going to write 1988 08 L. So that is indicate that I'm using the POSIX.1 version. So this is how we are going to include the constant before writing our program. So now one more constant it is going to support, that is the POSIX version, which is going to holds the value, that is indicate that what type of version you are using, whether the POSIX.1, whether the POSIX.1B or whether the POSIX.1C. So which version you are using in your program. So that is what the different versions of the POSIX. Now let us see with the simple example how we are going to make use of this constant as well as the POSIX version with the simple program. So we are seeing what are the two constant, predefined constant we are going to make use in our source program, that is the POSIX source and the POSIX C source. So this will be supported by the POSIX.1. So but here which is also supported by the POSIX.1B as well as the POSIX.1 and then the .1C. All this will be supported this constant. So here we are using both the constant. Next after that these two constant, the definition of these two constant we are going to write it in a header file. That header file we are going to call it as a unistd.h. So this is the headers we are going to make use in our source code to support these two constant. So the value we are using is 199309L, indicate that it is going to support both the POSIX.1 as well as the POSIX.1B. So with the simple example, we will see the how we are using this constant, that is the POSIX version. So int main, we are going to check whether the POSIX version, which is the POSIX version. So that is output, it is going to display C out POSIX, POSIX version. So what is the current version we are using? So else, which is not going to support this version, that is version is undefined. Here the system, whatever the program you are written, if it, the program is supported, then it is going to give the output that the POSIX version is 199309L, that is nothing but the POSIX.1 and the as well as the POSIX.1B. So this is what you are going to get as an output. Otherwise the version is undefined and the end if and then return 0. So this is the simple program we are illustrate the three constant, that is POSIX source, POSIX C source, and the last one is a POSIX version. So this is about the introduction of the POSIX standard. So next class we are going to see the what is the environment, so what is the test macros it is going to support, and what are the limits. So this is the three topics we are going to study in the POSIX standard. So thank you.